Sonic T Hedgehog here, also known as the Blue Blur, coming back at ya. Not to be confused with the Blue Bomber. Boy, wasn't it better when video game characters could be easily identified by a color? You know, Mega Man was blue, Mario was blue. Okay, this is as far as I made it in my attempts, because I would always try to do a ring dash there, and I would always be hurled down a bottomless pit. But now it looks like I'm going to drown instead. Awesome. So yeah, what was I saying? Oh yeah, colors in video games. I remember the day, by God, when, you know, skies were blue, grass was green, and, you know, video games were a pleasure to look at. Like, look at this. This is awesome. Sure, it might not have all the fancy new 3D graphics or, you know, real-time bump mapping or texture-based modus operandi. But damn it, it has character, and it's just pretty. Alright, let's see if I can do this a little faster this time. Let's, okay, that didn't work. Let's do that, and then that, and okay, yeah, that works. Alright, good. I should have plenty of time to get some air. Just hanging out at the air bar. Waiting for a bubble. There we go. You know, they replaced a lot of the music in this game. I wish they would have replaced that fucking music, because it seriously still haunts my dreams. Okay, blind LP coming up after this point. This is... okay. Yeah. Obviously that was blind, because otherwise I wouldn't have walked into a bottomless pit. I don't know if I really like this aspect of level design, because why do you have a bottomless pit underwater? That makes about as much sense as room temperature fire. Which, come to think of it, would be really awesome. As you would know if you've ever watched The Tick. And by The Tick, I don't mean that shitty show with Patrick Warburton and Bat-Manuel. That show was terrible. I mean, you know, the cartoon. Which was really one of the best cartoons ever. If you haven't watched it, then you're probably a failure at life. So yeah, go back and watch it. And no, the live-action show is not a substitute. You know what pisses me off about the most about the live-action show? Is that they changed Deflator Mouse's name to Bat-Manuel. And, you know, they changed him from, like, a German theme to a, you know, Spanish theme. I mean, what, do they think the Fox viewing audience was too stupid to understand Deflator Mouse? I mean, obviously it's German for the flying mouse, which is, you know, what they call bats. I mean, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure that out. But no, they might not know he's a bat if we call him Deflator Mouse. The audience will be confused. They'll be like, why are they calling him a mouse? He's a bat. So, they had to dumb it down a notch. You know, I still know people who think that... whoa. Post-level drowning. I know people who claim that the live-action Tick show was good, but to those people I say, you've never seen the cartoon, because the cartoon is just so much better. I mean, I guess I can't blame you for not seeing it, because it's not like they really show it anymore. I think they showed it on Comedy Central for a little while. But it'd be nice if Cartoon Network or somebody would pick it up. Or Adult Swim. Speaking of which... man, fuck Adult Swim. I'm so sick of seeing real people on Cartoon Network. Like the Tim and Eric shitty show. It's called Cartoon Network, not... People Network. I don't know, that was lame. But my point stands. Apparently this is going to be the Duke Bitches About Things LP. Ugh! I knew that was going to happen. Why did I do that? Oh well. I just lost the pointless non-elemental shield anyway. When there's a much better bubble shield right here. Why do they even still have the normal shield? They should just replace every instance of the normal shield with the bubble shield. Because, I mean, you know, it's just like the normal shield, only it lets you breathe underwater. What's not to love? And there's another one. A plain old boring everyday shield. Why is that even here? What's that button do? Oh, it probably opens this up. Alright. Blazing through this level. Sonic, he's really cool. Sonic, he's got an attitude. Sonic, he's the fastest thing alive. Time to go eat some chili dogs. Oh boy, I'm gonna have to jump on that spike platform and then jump up to the left. Okay, that could have been worse. Banging my head. So what do you guys think of these spastic videos? Are they better or worse than normal videos? Or are they the same? Because I can't really tell. Let's see. Go up and to the left. I'm just all over the place today. Apparently I did forget to set my phone because it never went off. And I forgot to set it again. So, keep one eye on Audacity, I guess. Hope I don't forget to look at it and play for 20 minutes before I realize what happens. Because I don't want to have to cut it at an awkward time or anything. That was a close one. Whoever said this game was hard is an idiot, by the way. Did I say that already, or was that in one of the old takes? See, I need to just stop doing multiple takes, because that's what happens. I forget if I said something in this video, or if it was in an alternate reality. Alright, this was the hardest boss in Sonic 1, and it's probably going to be the hardest boss here, too. Although, so far, the pattern doesn't look too different. It's mostly just, you know, I mean, I'm not going to say it's exactly the same, but it looks pretty similar. And I need some air. There it is. There's some air. Got it. Fuck you, Robonic. Trying to kill me. What's wrong with you? Well, if you're just going to hang out there, then I'm just going to keep hitting you. Oh, he left. Okay. Boy, I'm getting through these levels really fast. I guess I spoke too soon about the levels seeming to be longer. But I guess they're still reasonably long. I'm just not really dying that much or anything. But yeah, whoever said this game is hard, you don't know what you're talking about. Because I just beat the equivalent of the Labyrinth Zone. The hardest level in Sonic 1. And it was like nothing, man. It was like freaking nothing. I guess I didn't add any levels or anything to this because, you know, so far they've matched one-to-one with the levels from Sonic 1, so it's just going to be this and then the Megamix equivalent of the Scrap Brain Zone and then it's done. This is going to be a much shorter LP than I thought it was. But I mean, so far, Al, it's been pretty damn enjoyable. I've enjoyed it. Have you? Send me your feedback at duke@bumpington.org. Yep, that's my email address. I registered my own domain name and everything. Although I don't have any LP-related stuff at bumpington.org. You can still check it out. I write blog posts there occasionally. Lately, I've been reviewing movies that I watch on Netflix. Instant watch. I feel like I mentioned that. Maybe I was just talking about movies I've watched. But yeah, that's like my other project, although I haven't really put that much effort into it recently. I did watch a movie the other night called Slacker. It's I need to stay on that platform. It's like this indie movie that came out very early 90s, like 91 or something. And it was good. It's just hard to write about. It's hard to review. And really, it's hard to recommend because it has a very indie sensibility to it, I guess. I mean, you know, it's purposefully obtuse, or not obtuse, but just, like, surreal. It's like watching a fever dream. Alright, this has been Duke of the Bump, making pretty good progress in Sonic Megamix. Tune in next time, hopefully we'll finish up this zone and see what lies ahead in the future. Etc. See you then.